and fun. We're the Nirks.
Between Mars and Jupiter, there is a large void, an area to study that astronomers enjoy. A gap with a ring made up of millions of planetoids, or also known as a belt of asteroids. Hurtling through space in their orbit round the sun, these large irregularly shaped rocks have a lot of fun. Made up of different rocks and metals, each asteroid is unique. Let's go out and find some and see who we can meet. Let's go meet the asteroids. They're oddly shaped rocks. They're not spheroids. Careening through space in an expansive void. Most of them won't hit us, so don't be paranoid. Let's go meet the asteroids. Let's go meet the four largest known asteroids.
My name is Ceres, the largest asteroid to be discovered. But now I'm classified as a dwarf planet. My true self has been uncovered. I'm the largest known object in the asteroid belt, it's true. I have a thin atmosphere that could contain water vapor from my surface, too.
My name is Vesta, one of the four largest asteroids known. I have a unique surface like that of terrestrial worlds long ago. My surface used to be very active and was covered in lava flows. I have a huge impact crater so deep that my inner mantle is exposed.
My name is Pallas, the second asteroid discovered after Ceres. I have an eccentric inclined orbit. I like to orbit differently.
I'm the asteroid Hygieia, but scientists discovered that I'm round, which means I finally qualify, and I'm a dwarf planet candidate now.
Let's go meet the asteroids. They're oddly shaped rocks. They're not spheroids. Careening through space in an expansive void. A collision with one is something Earth should avoid. Let's go meet the asteroids. Let's go and meet some more asteroids.
I'm Ida. I'm special because I have a friend at my side. His name is Dactyl, my moon, and he's only about a mile wide. We travel in the asteroid belt together. It's good to have a friend beside me. There are hundreds of other asteroids that have moons or are binary.
I'm Bennu. I don't live in the asteroid belt. I orbit between Earth and Mars. I'm known as a near-Earth asteroid because from Earth, I'm not that far. NASA's OSIRIS-REx visited me in 2018 and made a discovery. I shoot out plumes of dust that create a haze around me.
I'm Itokawa, and I'm a near-Earth asteroid, too. I might collide with Earth someday, but we've got about a million years before I do. I'm the first asteroid from which actual samples were taken from me. Now they're back on Earth for scientists to study.
Asteroids range in size from really large to really small. But if you measured the mass of each asteroid and added up them all, the entire mass of all the asteroids in the asteroid belt combined is less than the mass of our moon Luna. That totally blows my mind. Not all the asteroids in the solar system are in the asteroid belt. There are near-Earth asteroids inside the belt and other groups further out. Made up of different rocks and metals, each asteroid is unique. Let's go and find some more and see who else we meet. Let's go meet the asteroids. They're oddly shaped rocks. They're not spheroids. Careening through space in an expansive void. Most of them won't hit us, so don't be paranoid. Let's go meet the asteroids. Let's go meet some more asteroids.
Patroclus and Manishi, yes, we're binary asteroids. We're not from the asteroid belt, but further out, Trojan asteroids. We share Jupiter's orbit in our journey around the sun. It's a much longer orbit than the asteroid belt, but together it's lots more fun.
I'm Kariko, not from the asteroid belt or Trojans. I live beyond this. I'm a member of an asteroid class known as Centaurs between Saturn and Uranus. I'm also very unique because of a very special feature, you see. I'm the first asteroid to be discovered with rings. I have two around me.
I'm near-Earth asteroid Apophis and will pass by Earth in 2029. But don't worry, I won't hit you. I just want to say hi.
Let's go meet the asteroids. They're oddly shaped rocks. They're not spheroids. Careening through space in an expansive void. Most of them won't hit us, so don't be paranoid. Let's go meet the asteroids. Let's go meet more asteroids.
I'm Eros, a near-Earth asteroid, one of the largest ones known. The inner asteroid belt is where I make my home. I was the first asteroid to ever have a spacecraft land on me. Mere Shoemaker landed on my surface after almost a year of study.
Entirely is their name. We're special because we're a double asteroid. We're twins, almost equal in shape and size, together in the void. We have a circular orbit around each other, and we hold on tight as we travel together through the outer asteroid belt, swirling through the night.
I'm Sylvia from the asteroid belt, and I'm very special too. The first asteroid discovered to have more than one moon, I have two. Their names are Romulus and Venus, and they orbit me. I'm a collection of very loose rock, a rubble pile, and I have very low density.
Let's go meet the asteroids. They're oddly shaped rocks. They're not spheroids. Careening through space in an expansive void. A collision with one is something Earth should avoid. Let's go meet the asteroids. Let's go and meet some more asteroids.
I'm Hebe, a large asteroid from an unstable part of the asteroid belt. I'm very bulky and dense and have very few impact collisions that I've felt. Impacts I suffer are affected by Jupiter's gravity and the pieces launched all about, which make up a large amount of meteorites that hit the Earth. You better look out!
I'm Cleopatra from the asteroid belt. I'm known for my very odd shape. A cross between a dog bone and a dumbbell is the form I take. I have two moons to keep me company and stay by my side. Cleo Selene and Alex Helios are their names, and I'm their guide.
I'm Icarus. I'm not from the asteroid belt. Centaurs or Trojans, you see. I have an eccentric orbit, and I come closer to the sun than Mercury. The first Mercury-crossing asteroid discovered, I also crossed paths with Venus, Earth, and Mars. On a near-Earth approach, I was the first asteroid observed by radar.
There are hundreds of thousands known asteroids in our solar system alone. Most of them are located in the asteroid belt, but that's not their only home. Some called Centaurs are between Uranus and Saturn. The Trojans follow Jupiter around. Apollo objects cross Earth's orbit, but hopefully won't hit the ground. Oddly shaped rock asteroids are not all that you will find. Some are hybrids that have other traits and classifications combined. Some don't act like an asteroid should, with odd orbits or color or size. Some are just unique nonconformists, and you won't believe your eyes. Let's go meet the asteroids. They're oddly shaped rocks. They're not spheroids. Careening through space in an expansive void. Most of them won't hit us, so don't be paranoid. Let's go meet the asteroids. Let's go meet some more asteroids.
I'm Chiron. I'm called an asteroid, but I'm a rare specialty. I'm also known as a comet because I'm icy and have a coma around me. I'm classified as a centaur because I reside between Uranus and Saturn, and I may also have rings, though they're not yet confirmed.
I'm Phaethon, a rebel, an asteroid-comet hybrid, that's me. My elliptical orbit brings me closer to the sun than any other named asteroid would dare to be. I'm the source of the Geminids meteor shower, which is a bit strange. I'm also blue, not brown, or gray, and was the first asteroid discovered by spacecraft in space.
I'm Katrina.
I'm Mr. Spock from the asteroid belt.
Just here for a quick chat. I'm the first asteroid named after a dog.
I was named after a cat.
Let's go meet the asteroids. They're oddly shaped rocks. They're not spheroids. Careening through space in an expansive void. Most of them won't hit us, so don't be paranoid. Let's go meet the asteroids. Let's go meet more asteroids.
Named after a Celtic god, I'm Trotatus, an odd asteroid. Instead of orbiting regularly, I chaotically tunnel through the void. I'm a double-lobed object, like a dumbbell. My two halves are barely connected. Probably why my orbit is so unpredictable, and I don't go where I'm expected. I'm a tiny asteroid. My name is 1994 CC. I'm not alone. I'm a triple asteroid, or trinary. I have two even tinier moons orbiting around me. We're a near-Earth asteroid, and we'll pass by Earth again in 2074, Us 3.
Dimorphos, an asteroid moon. I orbit Didymus, you see. NASA purposely sent the DART spacecraft to crash into me. They knocked a bunch of boulders off me and changed my orbit around Didymus slightly. This mission marked humanity's first success with asteroid deflection technology.
Let's go meet the asteroids. They're oddly shaped rocks. They're not spheroids. Careening through space in an expansive void. A collision with one is something Earth should avoid. Let's go meet the asteroids. Let's go and meet some more asteroids.
I'm 6478 Gold, a real oddball. I'm disintegrating slowly. I have a color-changing comet-like dust trail and two tails behind me. I'm shedding my outer red layer because of my very fast spin, revealing a blue layer beneath like a snake shedding its skin.
A near-Earth asteroid, 2021 BH27, that's me! The fastest asteroid discovered. I orbit the sun almost as fast as Mercury! 113 days is the time it takes me to elliptically orbit the sun. I get extremely hot. I could melt lead on my surface when I'm a perihelion.
Paracloth, a trans-Neptunian object found by New Horizons in the Kuiper Belt. I'm shaped just like a snow person, but don't worry, I won't melt. One of the farthest objects observed up close, I'm a contact binary asteroid, 2-in-1. I take 298 years to complete one orbit around the sun.
There are hundreds of thousands known asteroids in our solar system alone. Most of them are located in the asteroid belt, but that's not their only home. Some called centaurs are between Uranus and Saturn. The Trojans follow Jupiter around. Apollo objects cross Earth's orbit, but hopefully won't hit the ground. Asteroids are not just pieces of rock that orbit around our sun. Some are made of rare precious metals and minerals that are worth a ton. Some asteroids travel through our system from very far away. Mysterious visitors that pass us by, leaving more questions in their wake.
Let's go meet the asteroids. They're oddly shaped rocks, they're not spheroids. Careening through space in an expansive void. Most of them won't hit us, so don't be paranoid. Let's go meet the asteroids. Let's go meet some more asteroids.
I'm Oumuamua from beyond the solar system, and I have a strange elongated shape. I'm moving very fast back out of the system, and my speed seems to accelerate. My bizarre shape and color is puzzling astronomers because I'm not acting normal. Am I really an asteroid, or possibly a visitor that is paranormal?
A large metallic asteroid in the asteroid belt. I'm Psyche. You could be very wealthy if you ever got a piece of me. I'm worth over $10 quintillion because I've got gold, iron, and nickel on me. An exciting mission is planned to visit me in October 2023.
I'm Davida the Diva, covered in rare metals and minerals great for mining. I could be worth over $27 quintillion if you catch me.
Cha-ching!
Let's go meet the asteroids. Let's go and meet the asteroids.